today for our tailgating recipe, what I'm going to do is I got two slabs of Big Mac ribs right here. Here's another one. And what we're going to do today, because I'm basically out of snafu seasoning, I'm going to use one of my favorites, one of the family favorites, the brown sugar bourbon right here. Just sprinkle that rub on there. One of the things I did before, though, before I prep the ribs, is there's a membrane on the back. You just pull it right off of there. It's like this. It helps the flavor seep through on both sides. So when you rub your rub on both sides of the ribs, it'll meet in the middle, so to speak, and it kind of holds everything in. Plus, when you go to eat it, you don't have this piece of fatty tissue, grizzly stuff getting in your teeth. So we'll just toss that in the trash. And what we're going to do is we're going to rub some brown sugar bourbon on both of these, and then throw them on the smoker. Again, I'm going to do about 225. You're going to find out whenever I do something on a smoker, it's always going to be right around 225. For the pork loin I did last week, we left on there for about 6 to 8 hours. For the ribs, I'm going to put it on there on the smoker on a top rack. I'm going to put it on there for about 4 hours at 225 using some hickory. And then after about the fourth hour, I'm going to pull them off. And then I'm going to cover them with some brown sugar and honey, and then I'm going to wrap them up in aluminum foil. So I'm going to lay my aluminum foil down, sprinkle the brown sugar on it, squirt the nice good honey on there, put it back on there, then I'm going to throw it back on the smoker for another hour or so. Kind of let those flavors all mesh in together with the brown sugar bourbon. So we're going to go ahead and rub this on here. Get this all going good. Make another mess in my wife's kitchen. She's going to shoot me. It's a good thing she's gone. Well, she's actually right here watching me. She's not really gone. She just shakes her head and rolls her eyes at me. So we'll do it like this. And we'll do it on both sides. Kind of get the flavors to go all the way through. And then I'll do the other rib the same way. Kind of have it all together. Put some more on here. Get a nice good crust on it. This will be good if flavors are all married together. You'll have a great time with it. And these are good for your tailgating specials, tailgating parties at the track, because you can slice them down, put them in little baggies, you can take them into the race, or you can eat them back here at your tailgate before you go to the race where you're going to the Midway. So this is another on-the-road tailgating recipe of the week. And tune in next week to find out what I'm going to be cooking up next week. See y'all on the road.